Very good morning, students. How are you all? I know you must be fine. Yes? Students, we are going to start today new topic. But before that, just answer my few questions. When we go out for shopping, after shopping, shopkeeper gives us, very good, a bell. And we give the required amount to him. Same thing we are doing when we are purchasing vegetables, fruits, medicines, clothes. Yes? So counting of money, it is very important for us. So today we are going to start with a new lesson, that is lesson number 12, money. So when we give money to that shopkeeper, we give it in the form of rupees and paise. Yes? So rupees and paise, these are our Indian currency. We count money in rupees and paise, and this is the symbol of rupees. While writing in short form, we write it in this way. Okay, so whatever the rupee is there, 1 rupee, it means 100 paise. You have to keep it in mind. Okay, so now we will go little bit ahead of it. Now we will see how to convert rupee into paise. Okay, so let's take our first example. Our first example is rupees 30 that we have to convert into paise. So what is our formula? 1 rupee, it means 100 paise. Very good. So I will write it first. Okay, but we have to convert rupees 13 into paise. Yes, so I will write here rupees 13. So you have to keep it in mind that children, whenever we have to convert rupees into paise, we will multiply it with 100. Why only with 100? Because 1 rupee, it means 100 paise. Yes, so I will multiply 13 by 100. So after multiplication, we will get 1300 paise. Okay, so we have converted rupees 13 into paise, and what is the answer? Yes, our answer is 1300 paise. Okay, let's take one more example. Now rupees 36 and 75 paise. Paise we can write in the form of P also. Okay, so we have to convert this number into paise. Very good. So which formula we will use? Very good. We will write first 1 rupee, it means 100 paise. But we have to convert 36 rupees. Yes, so below this I will write 36 rupees. Okay, so now we will multiply this 36 by 100. Okay, because 1 rupee means 100 paise. Yes, so now what is the answer after multiplication? After multiplication, we will get 3600, it will be paise. Yes, but they have given 36 rupees and 75 paise. Yes, so this 75 is already present in paise. Okay, so we will add only these two numbers, 3600 plus 75. So it gives us 3675 paise. Okay, I hope all of you have understood these two sums. Now we will see how to convert paise into rupees. Okay, so let's take our first example. First example is 350 paise that we have to convert into rupees. Yes, so what is our formula? 1 rupee, it means 100 paise. So while writing here, as it is given paise, I will write paise first. Okay, 100 paise. It means 1 rupee. But now we have to convert 350 paise. Okay, so below 100 paise I will write 350 paise. So you have to keep it in mind while converting paise into rupees, we have to divide it with 100. Why only with 100? Because 1 rupee it means 100 paise. Okay. So 350 divided by 100. Okay. So now 100 carries 2 zeros. That's why I will underline last 2 digits of 100. And here also I will underline last 2 digits. So last 2 digits, that is the underlined part, will be our remainder. So here we will write it as paise and not underlined part, that is 3, which we called it as very good quotient. That will be our, yes, rupees. Okay, so I am writing it. So what is our answer? Here what we will get? Rupees 3 and 50 paise. Okay, so how we can write this? Our answer is, ₹3.50. Okay. Let's take one more example. 2750 paise, that we have to convert into rupees. So we will write first our formula. So 100 paise means 1 rupees. Now we will write 2750 paise, that we have to convert. Yes. So you have to keep it in mind, while converting paise into rupees, we have to divide it with 100. Why only with 100? Because 1 rupee means 100 paise. Okay. Hundred carries 2 zeros, that's why I have underlined last 2 zeros. As I have underlined here, I will underline here also. So the part that I have underlined, that will be a very good remainder. So here we will write it as paise, and the part that we have not underlined, it will be a quotient. So here we will call it as rupees. Okay. So what is our answer? 27 rupees and 50 paise. So while writing, we can write it in this form. So I hope all of you have understood these two sums.